fishing in the Carrick Roads, Cornwall, otherwise known as the Fal Estuary. I paddled out and dropped anchor in the deep main channel that runs through the estuary. And at the moment I'm anchored in about 103 feet of water. And it's an absolutely fantastic morning. The sun just coming up over the hill here. It's 7 o'clock in the morning at the moment, and I've got the bay to myself. And that's going to change after 9 o'clock because it's Easter, start of the season, and this will get quite busy here with traffic. My target species today is Thornback Rays. I start to fish for ray this time of year, and through a few times throughout the summer and autumn. And when you're fishing for ray, there's always a chance of picking up a bullhuss. So although my main target species is ray, there is a possibility of picking up a bullhuss as well. I've got the rod out at the moment. I brought some fresh calamari squid with me, but I've already managed to jig up a fresh launce, and which the rays love. I've got half a launce on at the moment, but got the squid as well. But I'm also going to carry on seeing if I can pick up some more fresh bait, whether it be launce or mackerel or herring, and I'll be using that as well. Particularly herring, I've had a lot of success with rays here with half a herring, so hopefully if I can pick up a herring, I'll try that. Alright, so I'm going to fish all day, starting off fishing the last hour and a half of the flood tide, but most of the day I'm going to be fishing the ebb tide, so it's not ideal, but as I say, it's absolutely brilliant out here, so hopefully I can get a few fish as well. At the moment here, as I say, I've got the bay to myself, but that's going to change later, and this will get quite busy here. It's Easter, and looking across to Mylor there, you can see all the boats out in the water there, and then there'll be the boats from St Mawes. So the estuary will get really busy with traffic. So what I've got with me today as an added safety feature, I brought I've got my flag, my red kayak flag here, because I've been told by one or two yachtsmen that sometimes they don't see kayaks, particularly when there's a little bit of a swell. They don't see them, which sort of surprised me when I heard that, and so I added a flag to my safety features that I've got on board to try and be more visible. So there's a little safety tip there, that these boats, they don't always see you out on the kayak, and so best to make yourself as visible as possible, particularly like I am today. I'm fishing here at anchor, therefore I could be quite vulnerable really in busy traffic. Got my first bite here. This is on whole calamari squid. So you can see it tapping away there. Okay, unfortunately not a ray. It's the inevitable dogfish that you get here. You always tend to get whenever you fish bait on the bottom. lesser spotted dogfish. The smaller cousin of the bullhuss. Fish is very quiet at the moment, so I thought I'd take some time to talk about the Fal Estuary. It was an ancient river valley that was flooded when the ice melted in the last ice age to become what it is today. And it's one of the deepest natural harbours in the world. The port of Falmouth across there. And when I first started living here 25 years ago, there used to be just one or two ships queuing to get in. But now, at times, there can be a whole convoy of them out in the bay there, waiting to get into the port. From a fishing point of view, it's a great resource for the kayak angler. When it's a little bit rough on the main coast, you can always get a bit of shelter here in the river. And the other great thing is, not very far from shore, far from land now, you can access really, really deep water. And at the moment, I'm fishing in 104 feet of water. And that's the deep channel that runs through the estuary. And of course, would have been the old river at the bottom of the river valley. For other species, there's very, very shallow banks scattered around. And just across there, where that buoy is there, that's the just buoy, just to the right of that, is what is known as the North Bank. And I'm in 104 feet of water now, but if I went across to there, I'd be in about 20 feet of water. So offers great variety for the rod and line angler, and get probably nearly all the species here that you can catch out on the main coast. Like most estuaries, there's sections that have become nursery areas for sea bass, and further north up the river is a bass nursery area that most of the year, apart from a few months, all bass regardless of size are protected. And if you are fishing up there for other species such as gilt-head bream, you catch a bass, it has to be returned. Okay, so that's just a little bit about the estuary. Very quiet at the moment, but as I say, probably a bit later on, this is going to become quite busy with a lot of pleasure craft, yachts and motorboats will be out here, no doubt, particularly on a nice sunny day like today. Bite here, the fish has been really quiet up to now. I managed to jig up some herring, fresh herring, so I've got half a herring on at the moment. Yep, let's go in now. So I find with ray, Thornback rays, sometimes they'll come in and pick up the bait and then swim off with it. Other times they'll come and just sit on it, and yep, okay. Unlike that particular fish there, it came in, there was a gentle tap, and then nothing. And as I say, sometimes they seem to come in and just sit on the bait while they're taking it in. So this is this is definitely a thornback, and if it's not a thornback, it's going to be a bullhuss. Like I said, I managed to jig up just one so far. Fish has been really quiet, not a lot of bait fish around either, and I managed to jig up just one herring. And I've got half of that on, so they seem to love herring here. It is a natural bait for them here in the estuary. Like I say, I can't be 100% sure that it is a ray until it's up, because it could be a bullhuss. One thing's for sure, it's certainly not a dogfish. Now God, I'm almost onto the leader now, so it should be coming up soon. Get back down, and it is a ray, small ray, small thornback. Small thornback ray, and for those of you that have never seen them before, thornback, they're called thornback because they've got these really, really lethal spines that run right along the back there and along the tail there, and they really are sharp. Way to handle them is there's a little section here you can grab hold, and make sure you don't cut yourself on the thorns. This fish is a male. And you can tell it's a male by these claspers here that they use when they mate with the female. They use to hold on to the female. There you go. Small male thornback ray. Beautiful fish. Taking a look at the tackle I'm using for this ray fishing, thornback ray fishing. I got my usual 7'6" 12 to 20 pound boat rod that I got that I tend to use when I bottom fish with bait from the Kayak. It's a Abu 6,500C multiplier, and it's got 15-pound mono, and it's a 30-pound leader, which is about twice the length of the rod. What I've got down at the business end, got a running ledger, just a straight running ledger with a boom there to help. The boom's very, very important, particularly here, fishing in about 100 foot of water. Therefore, when I lower it down, I lower it down slowly. The boom helps to prevent tangles when it's on its way down to the bottom. The trace is only about 3 foot long. I want this to sit hard, the bait to sit hard on the bottom. So I don't want a trace too long, which the bait might get picked up with the tide and start spinning. I've got a panel rig, two Varivas big mouth hooks, and they're the only reason I've got a panel is if I'm going to be fishing squid, it helps to present the bait a little bit better with a panel rig rather than a single hook. Just taking a look at the baiting up of this half of freshly caught herring. What I do is put the end hook of the panel rig through in the body and then back out. There. And then just bring the panel hook down, wrap it around the line about three times, and then through the herring. So there you are, that sits nice and straight. Like I say, here, this is just from my own past experience. Herring is absolutely brilliant bait for thornback rays here. I mean, you do catch them on squid, you catch them on mackerel, but I would say, just from my own catches, that either half a herring or half a launce seems to be an excellent bait for thornback rays. Just heading on in now, just the one thornback ray caught today, which is the small thornback ray caught earlier on. Pleasing to at least get one of the target species, although it's a fairly quiet day's fishing in general. A lot busier here now, the one I started out this morning. A lot more traffic out here, a few kayakers there, and a few pleasure boats being out here for the day. So it's been a good day, though the fish is fairly quiet, but as I said, pleasing to get at least get one of the target species. So thanks for watching.